Welcome back to the worldwide leader of all things Hanahan. I'm Macy Ducker. It's Friday, January 28th, and you're watching Hawk's Eye View. We are so close to the start of our new SOAR program, and Hawk's Eye View has all of the details. Take it away, Angel.
Thanks, Macy. The new SOAR program will be up and running this coming February.
So with SOAR, it's going to be a Tuesday and Thursday program where students have that, again, extra built-in time. We hope for students to pass classes, make up assignments, use time to further educational goals and get extra support, and then also identify with another adult in the building to answer questions and answer any needs they have.
SOAR is a program where students, it's similar to homeroom, where students will go to a new teacher every Tuesday and Thursday. It'll be the same teacher, but a new teacher to them on their schedule. They'll go on Tuesday. Tuesday will be a grade check. Teachers will check in on students' grades to make sure they're on top of their classwork, homework, to provide them different study habits, organizational habits, and things like that to try to improve academic success in all classes. On Thursday, that'll be a chance for students to go to their teachers to go to get one-on-one tutoring, group tutoring, for some of those students that can't come to our before school and after school tutoring. So it'll be an opportunity for them to, again, improve in the classroom, to build their academic success, and to be more confident while they're in their classes. The purpose of SOAR is to combat instructional loss, build relationships, increase academic achievement, and build school climate.
We're hoping to reach out to the kids who maybe can't come in the morning or stay after school, so they have a block of time during the school day to make up work or get some tutoring or some extra help. And students that don't need that will just get a break, which some of the kids need that too.
Make sure you check PowerSchool for your new homeroom teacher. Remember, the new SOAR program will be up and running this February after your second block class. Angel Coates, Hawk's Eye View. Now back to Macy in the studio.
Thanks, Angel. Black History Month is right around the corner, and Student Council is hosting a panel to help celebrate. Student Council representatives have prepared thoughtful questions for our speaker in order to gain a better understanding of Black history and how it impacts us today. The panel will be hosted via Google Meet on Thursday, February 17th at noon. Speakers will include Corey Brown, the Director of Photography at Tumbleston, Dr. Carissa Owens, the Director of Diversity Education and Training at the College of Charleston, and lastly, Olivia Williams, who is a National Park Ranger.
This is important because representation of African Americans and Black people and other people of color in media, especially in positions in which stereotypically they are not in those positions in most people's minds, is very important, and it's important for us to learn about.
In other news, you should have received your Renaissance card for the second quarter. Do you think that you qualified for a Renaissance card? Your second block teacher should have passed out your second quarter Renaissance cards on Monday. If your grade average was an 89.5 or higher and you had good attendance and discipline, you should be getting a platinum card. If your grade average was a 79.5 to an 89.4, you should be receiving a blue card. If you did not receive a card and have questions, or you want to get a free bottle of water, please see Ms. Cromer in her office right next to guidance. It seems like everyone has been going crazy over the newest Marvel movie. Dylan is here with the dealio.
Thanks, Macy. Just over a month ago, one of the biggest movies of the century came out to theaters. So here's the dealio on Spider-Man No Way Home.
You have a metal arm? That is awesome, dude.
Spider-Man is one of the most iconic superheroes ever. From movies to video games and everything in between, he has made an impact on millions of people. And No Way Home is no exception. With over 150,000 tickets sold in the first 24 hours, it has become one of Marvel's most successful movies. This is rightfully so, because all three actors, Tom Holland, Andrew Garfield, and Tobey Maguire, make appearances as their own version of Spider-Man. This crossover is what led to this movie's great success. However, one of the greatest moments from these surprise actors was not on the screen, but when they were hanging out. On opening night, Garfield and Maguire snuck into a theater together in order to watch No Way Home. In an interview with Entertainment Tonight, Garfield states, "Me and Toby snuck into a theater together, and no one knew we were there. It was just a really beautiful thing to share together." All three of these actors have played a huge part on thousands of people's lives for their roles in various Spider-Man movies. Now you know what's the dealio. Back to Macy in the studio.
Thanks, Dylan. Speaking of movies, what's your favorite movie that is based on a book? The library wants to know. Stop by the library during the month of February and tell them if you prefer the book or movie version of a specific story. You know prizes will be involved, so make sure to stop by. There was an epic girls basketball game Tuesday night that was almost right off a movie screen. Here's Jackson Zero with that story and a lot more in this week's HEV Sports.
Hey, Hanahan. I'm Jackson Zarin here with All Things Hawk Sports. First up on the agenda today, we have a thriller of a game for girls basketball. The girls took on the Cougars Tuesday night over in North Charleston. First up, Ashton Adams with a pass from Camden Lawson, putting up a hook shot. Ashton Adams again, taking it coast to coast, driving to the hoop and putting the Hawks up by three in double overtime. The girls came out on top in double overtime, winning 52-49. Great work, ladies. Now switching over to the boys' side of things, they were also on the courts on Tuesday. The boys took on North Charleston as well and came up just short, falling 67-44. That's all that happened this week. Now let's take a look at some upcoming events. First up, the girls will be taking on Oceanside at home Tuesday, February 1st at 6 p.m. They will also be playing Academic Magnet Friday, February 4th, 6:30 at Academic Magnet. Switching over to the boys' side of things, they'll be playing Tuesday, February 1st, 7:30 against Oceanside at home. They'll also be playing Friday, February 4th, 8 p.m. at Academic Magnet against Academic Magnet. Moving on to our next sport, Wrestling Region Individuals are Saturday, January 29th, 12 p.m. at North Charleston. Remember to head over to HawkAthletics.net for all the info on your Hawk games and athletes. Are you looking to play soccer? Tryouts are February 1st through 4th. The Google Classroom code is LNBZN2T. Join this for up-to-date conditioning, workouts, physical details, and interest forms. Tryouts are mandatory. Please reach out to Ray M at bcsdschools.net for any further questions. Boys soccer tryouts will be January 31st through February 2nd. They will be taking place at the rec fields starting at 4:30. You need a physical form to participate. That's all we have for this week, Hawks. Now back to Macy in the studio.
Thanks, Jackson. This winter weather has a lot of us dreaming about summer. With that in mind, Yosef went to find out when the Hanahan High Pool will be reopening. Here is the latest installment of Yo with Yosef.
Yo, 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 yo. Yo, 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 yo.
Yo. Yo, it's Yo with Yosef. These past couple years have been pretty bad, and I'm just trying to figure out what's the worst that can happen in 2022. Let's go find out.
What is the worst thing that could happen in 2022?
I don't know.
What do you mean you don't know?
Everyone could die, I guess.
It'd probably be like an earthquake.
If them vaccines don't work.
It does work. It worked on me.
It ain't work on me.
Why not?
Bro, I caught that junk the first day back.
Another lockdown.
I did it. I'm strong.
No, you're just
getting knocked out by your best friend.
Dang.
Remember when we all had to stay at home and do online?
Did that already happen?
Sadly, yeah. Everybody was doing it. Remember?
A repeat of 2020.
We all had a Chromebooks and we had to log in.
Bro, what are you talking about, man?
What happened in 2020?
What didn't happen in 2020?
Remember when we was, but everybody was at home.
What's the worst thing that can happen in 2022?
A new strain of COVID drop.
Yeah.
Do you think Mr. Gaz is gonna open up the pool again?
Yeah, why not?
The pool?
Yeah. Are you gonna use it for your team to work out in?
No, that's too easy of a workout.
Okay. We have a pool?
Yeah.
Where?
Top of JK building.
How we get up there?
Stairs.
I'm gonna go check that out.
It's on roof. What is the worst thing that could happen in 2022?
The aliens, man.
Uh,
I could gain more weight.
The Bermuda Triangle is a hole. The Earth is a donut.
Huh?
The Earth is a donut. The Bermuda Triangle is a hole.
The dinosaurs come from the toilets.
Those are some pretty bad things that could happen. But you know the worst thing that did happen in 2022? Is that pool getting closed down. Now back to Macy in the studio.
Thanks, Yo. That's all we have for you this week, Hawks. I'm Macy Ducker, and from all of us here at Hawks Eye View, we will see you next week. Have a great weekend, Hanahan.
That one there was a violation. Personally, I wouldn't have it.
I'm February 1st. Take two.
Thanks.
What's your grade, Math?
My grade's 100. Mm-hmm. I'm the smartest kid in the school.